Something unbelievable may have once occurred in the nation of Papua New Guinea, as across the lands you can hear stories about a fabled and destructive time of darkness. But this in of itself is not all that special, as similar stories can be heard in other parts of the world, such as in the Philippines, where various cultures remember the aftermath of a large explosive volcanic eruption. What is special is that in at least 5 separate locations, people all recalled the same thing. Specifically, that large stones rained down from the sky, crashing through roofs, damaging trees, and even harming people. And this occurred at locations which were a whopping 87 to 455 kilometers away from the eruption site, where the Long Island volcano produced Papua New Guinea's largest explosive volcanic eruption of the Holocene epoch in 1661. I have even heard rumors which I have not been able to substantiate from people who live between Sidor and Sternhorst, 2 towns that, while an island away, were close to the 17th century eruption site. These rumors claim that after the eruption, townspeople found small craters in the ground a meter to 3 meters in diameter, which were not previously there, reportedly being created by boulder-sized rocks that fell from the sky, some weighing several tons. So, is there any truth to these startling rumors? What about the 5 tales from different areas of the country who each distinctively remember falling volcanic rocks, quote-unquote, the size of stones? As if either of these reports had an element of truth to them, it could have implications for the planet's next VEI-6 or larger eruption, suggesting that people could be in danger far outside of the general exclusion zone radius such a large expected eruption would result in. For example, let us suppose that volcanic rocks could be thrown 450 kilometers away and that a VEI-6 eruption for an unknown reason suddenly occurred at Italy's Campi Flegrei volcano. Of course, there are no signs that this volcano is about to erupt anytime soon, no indications that it can throw large rocks such a distance, and no signs that its next eruption will be large, but just stick with me for this example. If volcanic rocks could be thrown up to 450 kilometers or 280 miles distant, not only would Rome, Florence, Pescara, Stromboli, and the majority of Sicily be in potential danger, but also the island of Sardinia, part of the French island of Corsica, and sections of Albania, Montenegro, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and Croatia. So, is there any truth to these reports? I spoke with a volcanologist in the country who told me, at the very least in his opinion, that the reports of falling stones on the Papua New Guinea mainland far from the eruption site are actually true. Supporting this assertion is the fact that on January 15th of 2022, the tallest eruption plume ever recorded occurred due to a powerful eruption of the Hunga-Tonga-Hunga-Haapai volcano in the nation of Tonga. In this 58-kilometer high eruption plume, which took only 30 minutes to go from ground level to such a height, a powerful updraft was recorded. This updraft was potentially as strong as 286 miles per hour or 432 kilometers per hour, being equal to the wind speeds of some of the strongest EF5 tornadoes. This caused large amounts of pumice ejected in the eruption to be carried high into the atmosphere. Subsequently, over the next 30 minutes, pumice fragments up to 6 inches in diameter fell across the populated island of Tongatapu, which was 80 kilometers from the eruption site. It is quite likely that a similar occurrence happened during Long Island's 1661 eruption in Papua New Guinea, but perhaps with a strong atmospheric wind that carried up to 10 centimeter diameter pieces of pumice to a distance of as much as 450 kilometers away. As for the rumors that several ton rocks traveled 80 kilometers during the eruption, not only am I unable to find any concrete evidence of this, but it seems essentially impossible to be true due to the general physics of such a theoretical feat. In summary, there is probably a select single-digit percentage of ultraplanean, aka VEI-6 or larger explosive eruptions, where occasional 10 centimeter or less pumice fragments can be carried over a distance of several hundred kilometers. Yet, it is probably quite rare, with 2 occurrences in the last 500 years. Thanks for watching. I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.